Since 1977, that makes it 34 years old. Well, I just returned to Zimbabwe, then Rhodesia, of course, from the UK, and. Then I started working as a journalist on a newspaper, just been launched, called the Zimbabwe Times. James at the time was a well-established disc jockey on Radio 3, ZBC, which is a commercial station of the state broadcaster radio. And he had a column in that newspaper, negotiated a column with the editor called Right On with JCJ, because he was always known as JCJ, which are his initials. And when he came to the newspaper from time to time to see the editor, that's how I met him. It's very, very up, established, but still on his way up as a DJ, successful as a commercial broadcaster, and somewhat on the hyperactive side, you could tell that the guy was ambitious, wanted to go to places, but at the same time, a very, very nice guy. So that's why it was easy for us to strike a friendship almost from the few days, first days that we met.
In the darkness, but the land is dry. Until the rain.
No, what struck me was when I started moving around with him and so forth. Now, as a commercial broadcaster, especially if your popularity is very high, companies seek you to sponsor your program because of your huge audience. So it almost was found it very, very interesting, because you must remember at the time most businesses were owned either by whites, Jews, or Asians. It's just how they just warmed up to the guy, despite the racial problems in the country, because he was doing well for them. The programs were working for them. So taught me a lesson that when people are doing well with you in a relationship, the issue of colors tends to fall away. Well, you see, here he was, the most successful commercial DJ, and you could tell. I mean, from the that was a time when segregation, in terms of residential segregation, was being scrapped. So those blacks who could afford to were now moving out of the townships. That's the time that James left Highfield, which is the biggest township in Harare. And then you could tell that he was on the way up financially. But then there was a restlessness about him. I recall one day he came to me and said, "Listen, I don't think I can achieve more as a DJ. I've reached my peak, I just feel it. So I've decided to go into the insurance business." So he went to work, not to work for, but to be in partnership with Old Mutual. And again, given his drive and his focus, became the most successful insurance salesman. At the time, I don't know if it still happens now, we were rewarded by a trip to the United States for what they call the $1 million round table. And if I stand to be corrected, I think he was only the second Rhodesian to achieve that. Thank you.